Hello, and welcome to Pinoy Fiancé Visa, Episode 4. Today, we're going to discuss what goes on in the Philippines after I had filed the Form I-129F application for Fiancé Visa. Jovi's going to discuss her experience while waiting for this information and after being contacted by the embassy. In the meantime, I'm driving to the bank.
We are here, going to the bank. As I start my story about the U.S. Embassy who contacted me after the application of Ken has been approved for that fiancé visa. The U.S. Embassy contacted me. I received a letter, a communication from the embassy stating that I am already available and to contact the St. Luke's Hospital for a schedule for my medical and physical exam. In contacting the St. Luke's Hospital, kailangan go online and there is an amount of fee to be paid. Kasi every time a fee is set, mayroon yung time na nag-i-increase sila. So, nung time na yun, medyo mababa pa. So, I was able to contact the St. Luke's. And then, later on, my schedule was set. And we went to Manila with my youngest daughter. Remember, I cannot go alone to Manila. Nawawala ako. Hindi ko kabisado ang mga street. At alam mo, mahirap nang bumiyahe mag-isa sa Manila. And we stayed there for 3 days. On the first day of our visit to the St. Luke's Hospital, we went to the registration first, and they're so strict. And then the following morning, we were told to go on empty stomach. Dapat walang tubig, lahat for blood test. And do all the tests needed for the medical and physical. Up to 3 days kami nag-stay sa St. Luke's. You have to, yung lahat yan may physical din, kailangan hubad, kailangan lahat yan makita. Unluckily, before my medical, 3 weeks before that, nabuhusan ang legs ko ng boiling water. So I have a scar in my legs. Naku, yan na ang problema. I was asked to visit the dermatologist and another doctor for a certification na hindi masama yung nakikita nila sa legs ko. So, after 3 days, medical is done. And thereafter, umuwi na kami. We flew back to Tuguegarao. So, well, the waiting period is it took months. Nung inantay ko yung result ng medical ko after few months, then I have to, there is an instruction that I have to make an account with the U.S. Embassy stating all the case numbers and other things there with passport number. Then doon ka mag-follow up. check mo yung status ng application. After months of waiting, I got the notice there in the US embassy na I'm already qualified for an interview with all the specified dates. So from that on, I got the scheduled date of my interview, and we flew again to Manila with my son. So when we went to Manila, I think we stayed there again for 3 days. The scheduled date of my interview, kailangan mag-appear ka sa office of the US Embassy very early, 3 o'clock again. Kasi ang haba ng pila and they are so strict. Ang mga documents that I brought during the interview are dummy emails, love letters from your fiancé, and pictures and cards or any document showing that you are in a relationship or you have been together with him. Then ang nag-interview sa akin, mga 5 Pinoys and isang Amerikano. Yung iba na Pinoy mas stricto kaysa sa Amerikano. And you have to know the details about your fiancé. You must know his birthday, the address, kung ilan ang anak, and some also ask paano mo na-meet yung fiancé mo. So that's all about the interview. Napakahirap. Pila-pila stricto from daming scanner and no gadgets inside the office. Nag-antay din yung anak ko dun sa labas kasi hindi pwede siyang pumasok. So, nung matapos na yung interview, umuwi na kami sa together ulit. Eto, yan na. Ang tiis-tiis lang magiging maglakad ng papeles. Okay, thank you. Ito yung parte ng sentro ng Brighton. 10 minutes from the residence.
Near the bank.
Near the bank.
Today is Sunday, so we're going to be using the drive-through ATM machine.
Yeah. I'll show you how ATM here.
Oh, people in the park.
Oh, there are people in the park.
First time
we saw.
Brand new park.
There the bank, Wells Fargo. Oh, ito na bangko. Well, ang bilis is dito, ang bilis ng magbangko. You can come inside the bank or you can just come here in the ATM booth. Cars are lined up here. Ayan, oh, sumunod na yung isang sasakyan. Kami na ang susunod dito sa block. We are done with the bank, so we are driving around the town. We are in where is this?
This is Bridge Street.
Bridge Street. Brighton, Colorado.
Much less traffic than in the Philippines.
Ah, yes, correct. Right.
No tricities.
No tricycles. It is. Oh.
Oh, there's Harley.
Yeah, Harley Davidson. So.
We'll drive by the high school and our church.
We will drive by the high school and in the Brighton United Methodist Church. This is now the Brighton Methodist Church. Dito kami nag-charge tuwing Sunday before the pandemic came.
So now, well, we usually come here. Lagi kaming pumupunta dito noon, pero after the this pandemic, nung medyo nag-open sila, eh, it is outside charts na. So antayin na natin na maging normal ang lahat. Ito yung pinagbibilhan namin ng vegetable. Lulus Farm Roadside Market. It is here where we buy all kinds of vegetables or organic fruits and vegetables. Here, we are passing by the house now. The roof is done. That's the house. So we are going to Henderson.
Now we're home. I'm going to turn the video over to Jovi.
And another document that the U.S. Embassy is the proof of
affidavit of support.
Now we are done with interview with medical.
Please
subscribe
and
like and comment. Thank you for watching. Mabuhay.
God
love you all. God bless.